when this celestial message of Srimad Bhagavad Gita was emanated from the lotus lips of Lord Krishna in Kurukshetra, in Punjab, in India. And there are 700 verses in this celestial book, divided into 18 chapters. The first 6 chapters belong to the yoga of action, karma yoga. 7 to 12, that is bhakti yoga, the yoga of devotion. And 13 to 18, that is the yoga of knowledge, jnana yoga. So it's a blend of 3 pillars. And if you understand and appreciate Srimad Bhagavad Gita, you got to understand these 3 pillars. Bhagavad Gita is a science of mind. It's a science of choices. There are a lot of choices. It is not like other disciplines that you have to do only this. No. If it does not fit into your equation, you have the option. So there are a lot of options. Depending upon the constitutional setup of our body, we are all different. We look different outside. There are 7.3 billion people on this planet. And each one is different. Shape, size, color, language, origin, everything is different. But inside, we are the same. Because we are born the same way, and we exit from this planet the same way. And that is the reality. There is no exception, there is no choice. The person who is born, he has to die. So, keeping into view all these aspects, there are a lot of choices in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. And today I want to share with you one particular verse. Patram pushpam phalam toyam yomi bhaktya priyachati tadaham bhakti upahritam ashnami priyatatmana. And when you offer something to Lord Krishna, Lord Rama, Lord Shiva, usually in the temple setup we recite this particular verse. What is the meaning of that? Patram pushpam phalam toyam. So 3 things, patra, pushp, phal. So what is patra? That is?
Leaves.
Yeah. And push?
Flower.
Flower. And?
Fruits.
Phal?
Fruit.
Usually, this is what we have been doing in the temple. We bring patra, pushp and phal, and we offer to the deity. That is okay. But the meaning of true interpretation of these 3 words, patra means your mind, but pushp means your intellect. So mind, intellect. And phal means the fruit of your action. Not santre, not kele, not sale. The fruit of your action, so Lord Krishna says, if you, with complete dedication and in surrendered mode, you offer these 3 things to me, then you are very near and dear to me, and I will take care of you from all sides. So now, we have to reflect on these 3 words. How to offer mind? We will take one by one. How to offer mind to Lord Krishna? Our minds are dirty. There is a lot of garbage. We are not selective in our thoughts. And garbage in, garbage out. Everything, whatever we think, passes through mind. The functionality of mind is to produce thoughts, millions and billions of thoughts at any given time. You are sitting here, You are listening to me, but I don't know what you are thinking. You may be thinking many things. So, that is the function of mind. And this distracted mind, this dirty mind, you cannot offer to Lord Krishna. You've got to be qualitative. When you offer something, if you want to give me a gift or to parents or to your boss, you take care of what you are offering. You wrap it, you select the right item, and then you offer it. But when Lord Krishna says, give me your mind, hum kehte de denge. But what you will give? Mind is dirty. It has to be cleaned before you offer. So dirty mind cannot be offered to the Almighty Lord Krishna. It has to be cleaned. And what is the litmus test of cleaning the mind? The mind will reflect the positivity. If you are positive, your mind is clean. If you are negative, it is not clean. Positive is a very strong emotion inside your mind. If you use that, everything is in the right direction. But if the mind is negative, whatever you do, whatever you touch, wherever you interact, you reflect that, and it's a contagious disease. Negative mind is a contagious disease. You continue to influence people through your negativity. So the mind has to be cleaned before it is offered to Lord Krishna. The other litmus test of cleaning mind is focused. Are we focused? Bhagavad Gita is the science of mind, and it teaches you a lot of techniques how to focus the mind. Chapter 6, Dhyana Yoga, it is all relating to how to focus the mind. So, the easiest way to focus the mind is to stay in the present. But we don't stay. Like physically we are sitting now, mentally we are, I don't know, I am just guessing, there may be among you who are really mentally also here. But usually it is not. So staying in the present means you are focused. So once you are focused, the quality of your work is par excellence. And it is applicable in household life, in community, in your office. If you are focused, your evaluation is par excellence. Nobody can check your advancement. Focused mind. All these scientists, all these research students, they are focused. That is what the research is. Focused, focused. They spend hours and hours and weeks and months sitting in front of the microscope, studying something, cell. That is focused mind. But Bhagavad Gita gives you another divine guidance. That is another way. And whatever Bhagavad Gita says, you don't have to buy anything from outside. It is already there in your system. But we must know, we must have the guidance and the technique and the awareness how to tap those resources. The resources are there, but we don't know the technique how to tap them. And to focus the mind, then comes up the 8th part of Patanjali Yoga, Ashtanga Yoga. Yam, Niyam, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. These are the 8 steps. And they all relate to the mind. The first 4 steps relates to the outer body, outer frame. And these last 4 steps exclusively digested in the mind, to focus the mind. And in chapter 2, Lord Krishna gave us the wisdom that we are not the bodies. We are living in the bodies. It is just a skeleton. So, we never die. We are the integral part of the Almighty. We never die. This outer frame dies, and we get outer frame many times, many times. There are 8.4 million evolutions on this planet, 84 lakh jonya. And human evolution, this is the apex point of the creation. Iske upar kuch nahi hai. And that is why the wise people have been shouting from the rooftop that this is the golden opportunity. Either you get it or you miss it. If you miss it, you have to repeat again this process of evolution. There is no guarantee you will become a human being again. It may take million years going through all the evolutions, depending upon the quality of our karmas. So, the idea I am sharing with you with utmost humility is that we have the freedom, and this is a golden opportunity. We invest on the outer frame most of our resources, but inside investment is minimal, but it should be the other way around. All our accomplishments, all our certifications, possessions, cars, houses, name, fame, they relate to the outer body, and they stay here because the body stays there. At the final departure, five elements merge into five elements, and all other things which we acquired, they also stay. You have seen that, you have witnessed many times in the cemetery, in the cremation. The guy is there in, for wake when they put the body there. He is alone. All his possessions are gone. So that is the reality. That is the reality. But it's not a pessimistic thought. It's an active thought, awareness, and the opportunity to fine-tune our day-to-day life. So the idea of focusing the mind, that is what the discussion is, how to focus the mind. I shared with you that stay in the present, be positive, and reflect on your routine. Most of the time, what you think when you get up and when you sleep, that span of 8-10 hours, waking state, what do we think? You are the judge, you are the jury, you are the witness, nobody can judge it. So honestly, if you analyze what I think most of the time, aapka bhi dekho, take a paper, write down, pen down 10 thoughts, most of the time what I am thinking. And you will be surprised, what we are discussing, it may not be there. We have a lot of other concerns, career, children, stock market, advancement in the job, relatives, children, their problems. So, and time is the only thing which you don't have. It is fixed. The day we are born, the time is ticking, and one day the clock will stop. So we don't have that much time. But we must understand the beauty of life, why I am here. The mission should be very clear to me. If the mission is not clear, then it is hotspots. Then we are jumping around and we are getting nothing. We get it, but then there is no time. We human beings are the product of our habits, practice. Jis cheez ki hum practice karte hain, hum wo ban jate hain. If you take swimming lessons for 6 months, you start swimming. You start jogging today, after 6 months you will be jogging very comfortably, right? And these marathon guys, they continue, after the marathon, they are walking and running the entire year. We are sleeping, but they are doing their exercise in the park because they want to become that. A 25-mile race, it's not child's play. There's a lot of many hours are spent on that to become that. So we are the product of our habits. So what type of habit we want to create, those should be qualitative. In chapter 12, there is a verse 12. Shreyo hi jnanam abhyasa, jnana dhyanam vishishate, dhyanat karma phalatyagasya tyaga chanti nirantara. Better than practice, this is what it means. Better than practice is the knowledge. I should know what should I practice. Agar main galat cheez ki practice to main kar raha hu, but that's the wrong practice. Aur jis ki iski main practice karunga, I will become that. That is a law of the creation. So better than practice the knowledge. I should know what I should practice. And then I have the knowledge and I am practicing. But the mind is not focused. Dhyan nahi hai. Dhyana. Dhyan is better than knowledge and practice. Kyunki jo bhi aapne karna hai, usme aapka mind nahi hai. So we will not get or achieve what we want to achieve. So again, the subject comes up again, the focused mind, how to create the concentration. And if we take these three steps, then there is a divine warranty of Lord Krishna. Chanti Nirantaram, whatever you want to achieve, it is guaranteed you will get it. And it is not a human guarantee or warranty, it is Lord Krishna's warranty. We believe in seer's warranties and other product warranties, and we are very happy, 3 years, 4 years. This is lifetime warranty and giving by the creator who created this creation himself, and there should not be any doubt. People who doubt, they are the failures. Because either you do the research or you believe the research. Sitting on a chair, you can make many ideas. But if the question is, did you do any research or you are just making up? But what the wisdom of Bhagavad Gita is, the brilliant and the brightest minds for centuries, they invested so much time to explore and to authenticate the validity of these statements. And they came up, no, it is true. So we should believe. We should believe that. We should not doubt it. There are two things. One is Shraddha and one is routine, Andhvishwas. Ek hai Vishwas, ek hai Andhvishwas. Vishwas, it is the knowledge-based conviction, that is called Vishwas, knowledge-based, and you are practicing that. And Bhagavad Gita belongs to that category. One, ek hai Andhvishwas, blind faith, jisko routine kehte hai, ritual kehte hai. Thali mein phool rakh diye, dhoop batti jala di, aise gumani shuru kar di. Pata nahi main kyun kar raha hoon, kya kar raha hoon. And we are doing day in, day out, and we are satisfied that we did that. Aarti ho gayi. No. Bhagavad Gita says, move the thali of your mind all the time. Then you will get something. Because that is the knowledge base. Mind is the window through which you can peep Lord Krishna. But you must know the technique. So the idea, we are coming back again to the central point, how to focus the mind. So I shared with you 2 points. One, stay positive. Second, stay in the present time. And third, revisit yourself. What most of the time I think, create the quality in your thinking. And thinking becomes at the optimum qualitative level when you think for others. Others means creation. Make this more beautiful with your efforts. If you are intelligent, share your intelligence with the society. Give it back. If you have health, tell them how you are healthy, what you are doing. If you have wealth, share it. Share it. So if that type of thinking is there, that is called selflessness. It expands you. It makes you bigger. But if you are selfish, thinking of you, your children, your family, your house, your car, your job, it will restrict your personality. It will put you in a cage and you will be deprived of the fresh air. You will be in the box. You will be in the box. And today the mantra of corporate world is think out of the box. People who are adopting that strategy to thinking out of the box, they become global. Hum jab bhi puja karte hain, puja ke last part hota hai, sarve bhavantu sukhina. Do we say that? That everybody should be good, healthy, wealthy, everything, sarve bhavantu, unko sukh mile. But do we mean that? Do we really mean that? It is just to be remembered. But we don't mean anything. Because we don't know our next door neighbor. Nahi pata. Hum gharon mein rehte hain, right? You don't know your neighbors. It may be a Chinese, Korean, Spanish, Haitian, but he is a human being. So if I don't know my neighbor, and I repeat in front of Lord Krishna, sarve bhavantu sukhina, am I kidding? Am I kidding? He knows. Jisko aap keh rahe ho, he knows everything. He is not sincere. He is a fake person. फेक भक्त है ऐसे ही कह रहा है इसकी कन्विक्शन नहीं है इसने कहीं से सुन लिया है या पढ़ लिया है बट ही डज नॉट अंडरस्टैंड वी टॉक अ वर्ल्ड पीस राइट देयर आर लॉट ऑफ वेरी गुड स्पीकर्स यू गो टू द यूएन नाउ वर्ल्ड पीस इज वन ऑफ द टॉप मोस्ट प्रायोरिटी बट पीपल who is at the podium and saying about the world peace, he is not at peace. He may have a fight this morning with his wife. He is not peaceful, he is excited, agitated. He is just saying that. So Bhagavad Gita says, reflect back and see most of the time what you think during the day. And adjust that. Reset that. Recondition the mind, that this is the way, this is the way. So, become selfless. The more selfless you are, the more focused you are. These are research-oriented, I am making up these things. These are research-oriented statements. Become selfless. And make the creation more beautiful with your contribution. Don't destroy it. Don't destroy people around you, and charity begins at home. I have been stressing more than enough. Charity begins at home. The relationship between wife and husband, it should be very qualitative. The person who is sitting, living with you, 24 hours, all the time, food, the same food, bed, the same bed, resources, common. Bank balance common, all of the things are common. And still, if you misunderstand your partner, you miss the point. You miss the point. Does not matter what are my achievements are. And if you are excited and agitated when you are leaving your home, the moment you interact with anybody, your contribution is nil. You are exciting people, you are agitating people. there's a road rage only because you are excited and agitated. If not, if you are peaceful, you will give the right of way to others and they will wave you from the closed window. You will silently transform those people. This is how the perception changes. You didn't do anything. You are still in the car. But you did something and you changed the people around you. This is how it works. This is the knowledge of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. You didn't do anything. So, focused mind, the other lip perspective is sensitivity. How sensitive you are. How much sensitive you are. This view of sensitivity is selflessness anyway. When you are selfless, you are very sensitive. When you are selfish, sensitivity is zero. Zero, big zero. And that is a no-no for the spiritual growth. Spiritual growth. So we are talking again about cleaning the mind because we have to offer it to Lord Krishna. So take these steps, clean the mind, and then you offer it to Lord Krishna, and it will be accepted. Otherwise, it is a mirage, it is a misconception, it will never be accepted. Dirty things you are offering to the Almighty Lord Krishna, it will never work. Aap dirty koi present wrap karke apne boss ko dekar dekho, it does not work. So if it does not applicable to the human being, who is your boss? Who is the boss of the creation? Who created the celestial setup? And you want to offer something to him, be careful. The quality should be the highest quality. So clean the mind. Patram, clean the mind. Clean the mind and then offer it. I gave the example many times. You go to temple, we all go to temple, and we buy something, like fruit. What is my intent at that time? Should I pick up the best, or I should go to BJ and whatever is sasta, I should pick up that. There are more kele, more santre. Or you are quality oriented, no, I am offering to Lord Rama, Lord Shiva. It should be the best. Or I should ask the storekeeper, give me the best, I am going to temple. We don't do that. Jo left over hota hai, hum kehte hain, chalo mandir mein de denge, log le lenge. Are you kidding me? And it does not work that way. So I have to change my thinking. So whenever I go to temple, or anybody goes to temple, that should be the state of my mind, the best quality I should pick up. Take one fruit, if you want to offer, but it should be the best. Because it reflects how you think. He does not want our kele santre, jinko aap offer kar rahe ho. He creates billions and trillions of those. It is your feeling, how you present it. So that is how you clean the mind. Clean the mind. So keep clean the mind with these steps and then offer to Lord Krishna. That is called surrender. 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 You have to take steps. Second part, intellect. He says, patram pushpam, phalam toyam. So patram, we discuss, leaf is the mind. So whenever you want to offer mind to Lord Krishna, clean it, and then offer it. Otherwise, hold it. Second is the intellect. Mind's functional ability is to produce thoughts at an enormous rate. Different types of thoughts, and it flies all around in this space on the planet. But that has to be screened There is a screening process. Intellect means screening process. Those thoughts passes through a process which is called intellect. Intellect. And jinki intellect is working properly, their screening process is very good. And they hold only the best thoughts, and the other they let it go. This is called deleting and saving process. We do on a daily basis with our computers, on our cell phone. We get 500 emails, but at the end of the day, you know the memory is a question. So you delete 499, the one or two or three or whatever, the best one, which are reference purposes, you save those, and all other junk you delete. Do we do that? This is a computer, information is, everybody knows we are doing that. But we don't do that on us. We never delete. We never delete. And our process is also the other way around. Those things which should be deleted, we are saving. And those things which have to be saved, we are deleting. And I can share with you one point. आपने मैंने आपकी बहुत हेल्प की 10 years एंड यू नो आई हैव डन लॉट फॉर यू बट टुडे व्हेन आई मेट यू आई एम जस्ट मेकिंग अप नॉट यू मी टुडे आई सेड समथिंग टू यू एंड नाउ यू आर एंग्री एट द एंड ऑफ द डे यू विल सेव दिस today's things and all other things you will delete. Ke Kapoor sahab ne, how he can say this thing to me? I never expected. But I will totally forgot, you will all totally forgot, but he did 99% good to me. It may be a bad day, it may be a bad day for me or for him or whatever. But usually we will practice this. So we will hold. We will save this bad event, but we will delete the goodness for years. Bhagavad Gita says, don't do that. This is a better way. Delete the demerits of others and save the merits of others. Reverse the process. And it's doable. You can do it. People have done it. Who are practicing that art? You, आपने किसी को लेना देना नहीं है. You don't buy any app, new computer. नहीं, ना जो है, that you have to, you must know how to tap the resources. So reverse this. This is called intellect. Reverse this process of screening. Delete the demerits of others intentionally. And save the goodness of others. Then your intellect is fresh and is holding good thoughts. Because you are practicing this now. If you are doing to me, you will be doing to others also. Because that is your habit now. And the other day we discussed this, that anything done on a consistent basis with perseverance, dedication, commitment, anything, and everything for 6 months, that becomes your habit. Then it is a reflex. Then you don't need any, like we are driving now, right? Everybody drives. How many functions we do while driving? But there was a time when you enter the highway, you are choked to death. New drivers, when everybody started driving, we were scared to go on the highway. But now it's a fun. You zoom, you enter it, everything is flowing because you have practiced it. In spirituality also, people are exactly entering and exiting from the spiritual highways, exactly with that comfort. They look the same, they dress up the same, they eat the same, but they know the technique. And whomsoever they interact, touch, talk, they change, they make them positive. Because you give to the society only what you have. If you don't have, you cannot give. You cannot give. So change starts with you, with me, with everybody individually. Whatever you want to bring the change, first of all, change yourself. So this is how to clean the process of intellect. Because if the intellect is not screening, mind is producing thoughts, lot of thoughts at any given moment. But my screening process should be at the optimum level. Only those best thoughts should pass and preserve. So use the system of deleting and saving through your intellect with judicious mind. Do that. जिससे आपने माफी मांगनी है, आपने किसी को कुछ कहा होगा है, go and ask, don't hold it, but we are holding it, don't do that, this screening process will not work, this is my process, I have to do it. कोई करता है कि नहीं करता, it is not my responsibility. But you change and then you will make the change to others. So the best way to clean the intellect process, save the goodness of others and delete the demerits. The intellectual screening process will be at its optimum level. Believe me, it works that way. Then offer this intellect to Lord Krishna. Because he is asking Patra Pushpa. Now comes the question of Phalam. Now it is not Kele Satre. It is the fruit of your action. Fruit of your action. So, what is the fruit of action? Anybody? What is the fruit of action?
Whatever you do it, uska jo phal and consequences jo hoga, aage kya hoga? Pata nahi sahi bola ki
nahi. Nahi, we are all students. You know? So, what is fruit of action? I'm just asking.
Is a result, like you said, the result of your actions.
Action.
We don't have control of the result, but whatever it is, that's...
So, reflection of your action.
The same? Okay. So, the fruit of action is the expectation. Whatever you are doing, you have some expectation. Bhagavad Gita says, and Lord Krishna says, give me that. तो फ्रूट ऑफ एक्शन आप ये मुझे बताओ किसका अच्छा होगा हु इज अडॉप्टिंग द राइट मीन्स इफ द मीन्स आर करप्ट द एंड रिजल्ट इज करप्ट पीरियड बट थ्रू टेक्नोलॉजी इनसाइड इंफॉर्मेशन एंड अदर टेक्निक्स विच आर अवेलेबल दीज डेज बाई करप्ट मीन्स You get the best result. By corrupt means, by adopting corrupt means, the result is you get the best result. Overnight you become rich. If I give you inside information of stock and you invest, next day you are a millionaire. Right? This is what you wanted. Right? The means were corrupt. So I should understand this, that the result has to be corrupt. I became millionaire, but I am a corrupted millionaire. I will not stop there. Now what I will do? I will start doing Mata ka Jagran. 10,000 hither de diya, 50,000 is mandir ko de diya. You are corrupting those entities also. Because there is a corrupt money. But it is a thinking. I have to think it. It is better not to give or give $1. Then give 1 million corrupted money and you are corrupting the entity. And it's a contagious. All those people who are touching that type of corrupted money, their hands are dirty. But I have to think. So Bhagavad Gita's wisdom is adopt the right means. Means should justify the end, not the other way around. So if the means are honest, right, jisko dharma kehte hain. Dharma means the value system. Value system means the creator created this creation and he made a rules. And that set of rules is dharma. You create a corporation and you prepare the article of association. Or everybody's duty is defined and they must follow those. Whosoever disobey bylaws, he is in trouble. The same way, the creator, Lord Krishna, who created this whole phenomenal world, he made the rules of do's and don'ts. And that is called dharma. And that is why in English we call it value system. So if you follow the value system, which is dharma, and do your karma according to dharma, then whatever the result is, Lord Krishna says, give that to me, not corrupted result. This is what it means. Okay, give me the fruit of your action. So action has to be based upon dharma, value system, honest means, not corrupted means. And whatever the end result is, which has to be good, that is the underlying wisdom of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, that it will be good. And that goodness should be offered in the thali of your mind to Lord Krishna. Ye aapke arpan hai. That is called phal ka tyag. So patram, mind, pushpam, intellect, and phal, the fruit of your action, by adopting your right means and doing your karma based upon dharma, whatever the result is, which has to be good, this is a silent warranty, it has to be good, offer that to Lord Krishna. And that is the essence of that particular verse. Jo hum puja ke baad kehte hain, patram pushpam. हम यही समझते हैं कि ये केले संतरे थोड़ा देंगे तो ठीक हो गया. नो, नथिंग. भगवद गीता इज अ साइंस ऑफ माइंड. एंड इफ यू डू द टेक्निक देन यू आर द मास्टर. सो बिकम द मास्टर ऑफ योर माइंड, नॉट द स्लेव. बट यूजुअली वी आर स्लेव. स्टे इन द प्रेजेंट, माइंड विल बी फोकस्ड. Become positive, the mind will be focused. Become selfless, the mind will be focused. Otherwise, mind will not be focused. And until the mind is not focused, whatever we do, it is not qualitative. And you cannot offer that process to Lord Krishna. Do we have time?
Yeah, we can go to, I don't know what time it is.
10 to 12.
Yeah, up to 12. Yeah, 7-8 minutes.
Okay. So, in the context of Srimad Bhagavad Gita Jayanti, we share this wisdom of this particular verse. And I would like to share with you a few more thoughts about Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Srimad Bhagavad Gita is a juice of Vedas, four Vedas, Shastras, Upanishads. There are 154 Upanishads. And there is no writer. They are all anonymous. The juice of all that wisdom, it is in Srimad Bhagavad Gita in 700 verses. So see the seriousness in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Arjuna asked 84 questions, which is the flight of the human being. When you don't want to do anything, when you resist the temptation not to do something, out of those 84, you will craft one. There cannot be 85th, because that is the flight of human being, not to do something. So he initiated 84 arguments through his mind, and Lord Krishna gave 576 answers. Usually, Bhagavad Gita is a dialogue between man and God. Man is Arjuna, which we are. God is Almighty Lord Krishna. He gave 576 answers. But in a dialect form, it is usually one-to-one. Aapne mujhe ek cheez poochi, maine aapko ek cheez bata di. But look at the benevolence, the kindness he gave. 576 answers. So see the seriousness. How much wisdom is embedded, and it is coming from the right source. There's no contamination. Nobody else is saying anything. It is Lord Krishna. So each and every word unquestionably has to be believed. And believe, I shared with you before, it should be knowledge based. That is called Shraddha. Your belief must be based upon the knowledge. Knowledge-based conviction is called Shraddha. Ignorance-based, it is a ritual. Aap kahin ja rahe ho, pata nahi hai. Andhvishwas hai. And then, more than that, in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, if you recite one verse, pick up any verse, recite that verse 1 week. 1 week. Start from, there are 700, it will take, you can calculate how much time it will take, but you start one verse and repeat it 1 week. It will go into your memory column. You will never forget it. On a very private note, usually I don't say that, but with utmost humility, I should be forgiven. I was not the student of Sanskrit. In 81, a great man from India, Swami Hariharji Maharaj, he came to New York. We were living in Queens, and there was a son in somebody's apartment. They called, so we went. So it was a beautiful satsang. After the satsang, there was a big line getting the prasad from Swamiji. So I and my wife was also, we were young at that time. And we were also in the line. When my turn came, he asked me point blank, Beta, Gita, Bhagavad Gita padhte ho? Main kaha, Swamiji, hum to Bhagavad Gita nahi padhte. हम तो पिक्चर में देखते हैं, वो कपड़े में लिपटी होती है और लोग कहते हैं कि इस पे हाथ रख के कहो, जो कहोगे सच कहोगे, सच के सिवा कुछ नहीं कहोगे. And he left. And then he became serious. He said, बेटा, ये ज्ञान का सागर है, ये भाव सागर है, इसमें इतनी मोती है. Study it, digest it. And then you do my work. And he touched my forehead. I was totally electrified. This is very private information. And because it's the Gita Jayanti, I want to share with you. I said before, I was not a student of Sanskrit. I was a student of law. I'm an attorney by profession. And I started writing down one verse on a piece of paper. And we used to commute. I was working in Manhattan. By the end of the day, this was my determination that it should be memorized. Meaning I don't care, that will come later on. So I started the process. It took me 12 years to memorize 700 verses of Srimad Bhagavad Gita without knowing the language. But that the miracle was, once this process was over, meanings were unfolded. Now you can talk hours and hours on Srimad Bhagavad Gita. This is how Bhagavad Gita changes and can change and have the ability and resources and the wisdom available to all of us to change us. So study Bhagavad Gita. It will change you. Jai Shri Krishna. Jai Shri Krishna.